I'm the Zach Monson. Welcome back to a very special edition of Pause Play here at Canadian Music Week, where we talk to Tyler Shaw about his new single, Wicked, touring with Selena Gomez, and guitars covered in fairy dust. Check it out right now. Tyler, thanks so much for coming on the show, man.
My pleasure.
It's so good to see you. It's been about a year and something since I've last seen you.
Yeah.
You've grown up so much, Tyler.
Really? Think so.
You've grown up. So think back to being 13 years old.
Okay.
Tell me about finding a guitar under a staircase.
It was pretty much like a movie, I found. Like,
as in there was somebody filming you at all times?
All that. Yeah. You know, you open the basement door.
Yeah. And you hear like a harp or something?
Yeah, something like a bling. Yeah. And then there's just an old guitar case in there. I obviously pick it up and blow the dust off.
Of course.
Open it up. A light shines in. Yeah. I pick it up and I just start playing.
Wow.
Yeah.
It is just like a movie.
If half
of that story is true, then it's exactly like a movie.
Well, I'll give or take a few things. But
do you remember the first song that you wrote?
Yes. It was called The Tara Song.
And
it
was a Tara Song?
Yeah. Okay. It was about a girl named Tara.
Tara.
Yeah.
I knew
you could have guessed that.
Yeah, I knew it.
And it was very bad.
How did it go?
I actually do remember this. It's awful, but I'll do the first little. It's like.
Can't wait.
And I'll sing it like how I used to sing it, too.
Well, I would assume nothing
else. It's like, the first time I saw you were all right, it doesn't mean you're okay this time. Something. It was really bad.
Tara.
And now,
where does the word Tara come in, though?
I don't remember.
It wasn't in the song.
Don't remember.
All right. Well, I think that should be your next single, is what I think.
Maybe not.
Yeah. You just participated in the launch of the Invictus Games.
Yes.
You were like a high five away from the Prime Minister and Prince Harry. Tell me a bit about that.
It was probably the most nerve-wracking thing I've ever done.
Okay.
Locked eyes with Prince Harry.
Yeah.
Had a moment. It was really weird. I think I did like a bow or something. I don't know. I was like,
you're never
I
sure
don't know what
to
do
with royalty.
Yeah.
Do you bow?
You salute?
Do you do one of like these?
It was weird. But I nailed the anthem, played a little song for them, and it was a lot of fun, and I'm glad
awesome.
I killed this.
Yeah. As long as you didn't curtsy, I think that's really the one thing that you really just can't do.
Yeah.
The new single is Wicked.
Yes.
Tell me a bit about the song.
We wrote it this past August. It was kind of a departure from the little things we were doing. We kind of wanted to grow up a little bit. You know, the past songs that I've had, Kiss Goodnight, By My Side, those were kind of like, you know, hey, here I am.
Yeah.
But I actually wanted to establish myself as an artist. And I think coming off of the single House of Cards definitely kind of solidified myself in the industry a little bit. And now this song that came out, Wicked, is definitely like, here I am. I'm here to stay. Like, I'm going to be releasing stuff like this from now on.
So what image do you have in your head when you hear you're wicked when you work it out? What is the image in your head?
You know, that lyric specifically was just like, we loved the alliteration on it.
Yeah, okay.
Wicked when you work it out.
Yeah, wicked
you know?
When you work it out.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It was a lot of fun to sing.
It almost sounds like a DJ scratch a bit.
Yeah, a little bit. But it was basically just like, the whole storyline is like, you know, you're in London underground, whatever, this small club, and you see a girl on the dance floor kind of thing, and she's working it, you know, she's working it out, and she's wicked about it, so
The album is Yesterday, and there's, you know, I mean, it's, you know, obviously, you know, a new album, but there's no collaborations. When can we expect a collaboration from you?
I'm actually working on right now. I just wrote a song in New York. I was in New York for 2 weeks, and we're trying to get a feature. I can't say any names right now, but we are working on...
You can give me some clues. You can hint at some stuff, though.
Blonde hair.
Blonde hair.
There you go.
I know who it is.
Ooh.
I know who it is.
Anyway, we're working
it's
on...
It's Britney
we're working
Spears.
On.
That's who it is.
Oh, my gosh.
I called it.
No.
The unfortunate thing, you were supposed to tour with Kelly Clarkson. That kind of fell apart.
Yeah.
But then here comes Selena Gomez inviting you into her show. Tell me a bit about that.
Everything happens for a reason, you know.
Yeah.
Kelly didn't work out, but...
She wasn't wicked when she didn't work it out.
She's super, super nice. But unfortunately, that thing fell through. But like I said, everything happens for a reason. So going on this tour with Selena Gomez is going to be life-changing. I'm so grateful for it. And I'm actually going to rehearsal right after this to kick it off. So,
yeah, that's awesome. You know, you're a big social media user. Your fans love you. What happened on January 19th of 2016 when your Instagram went entirely black and white forever?
You know, it was, we actually did a photo shoot in the fall, and then they gave us some edits that were black and white.
Yeah.
And I posted a black and white photo, and I was like, we should just keep this going. Like, it's kind of got a cool feel to it, so we just stuck with it, and I think we're going to stick with it until we release some new music.
Looks real classy, buddy.
Thank you.
Looks real classy. Thank you. So we asked the last artist that we had in to ask you a question.
Okay.
The band is Walk Off the Earth.
Okay.
And the question for you is...
Yes.
What's going on, you guys? We are Walk Off the Earth, and this is our question for you. What would you have written on your gravestone?
What?
Wow, that is a great question. Legend.
Legend. Just capital letters. Legend. Legend.
I don't know. Maybe something like loving father and grandfather and husband.
Even if you don't have kids or a wife.
Yeah.
You still should just say loving father, loving grandfather.
And then at the bottom, legend.
Legend.
Maybe. Yeah.
Can you get stuff on the back? I feel like you're really missing utilizing all the gravestone if you only have stuff on the front.
Yeah, but I think you pay per letter.
Oh, okay, no, right? I'm cheap. No. Just a big Z is all I'll have
right.
on mine.
Right.
One letter is all I need.
Yeah.
What was the first and the last album that you bought?
The first one, I'm pretty sure, was Silver Side Up by Nickelback.
Okay.
I think, is it?
Get Out.
I'm sorry. And the last one was the new Bieber album. Purpose.
How good is it, eh?
I love it.
It's amazing how often Bieber comes up in interviews. I don't know why. It's like 50% of our interviews, Bieber comes up in conversation.
It's just a thing, I guess.
The new album's fantastic.
It is.
I'll admit it. I love it.
Yeah, I love
it too. It's fantastic.
Yeah.
What is your favorite song right now?
My favorite song right now would have to be... Actually, there's a song by Tori Kelly and Ed Sheeran that I really love, Made for Loving You.
So good.
I love that tune.
Ed Sheeran, what an amazing writer
yeah.
that guy is.
Yeah.
He's unbelievable.
Always.
That's who it is. That's who your collaborator is.
Who?
Ed Sheeran.
Maybe.
He's kind of blondish. He's a strawberry blonde.
A strawberry blonde.
A strawberry blonde.
Yeah, that makes sense.
What is the best or the weirdest thing that a fan has ever done?
I actually haven't had, thankfully, too many like weird encounters. Like the weirdest thing would maybe being like, oh, here's my bra. And they're like, don't even sign it. Just here's my bra.
Just as a gift. Taking it off their body. Here it is for you, still warm.
Yeah, it was weird.
How
that was like the weirdest thing.
How do you
thing,
thank somebody for a gift like that?
You shrug your shoulders and say thank you.
Thank you?
Yeah.
Like a question?
Yeah.
Super awkward.
Very.
Super awkward.
Super awkward.
That's really, really awkward. Who are some Canadian bands that you love right now?
I'm always a big fan of Dallas Green, City and Color.
Amazing.
Sean Hook is doing amazing things, of course.
He is doing amazing things,
yeah.
Eh?
Walk Off the Earth, always a good favorite. So there's tons, though. You got like Shawn Mendes, Bieber, Drake, The Weeknd. There's tons of them. It's amazing.
Walk Off the Earth, I think, is the nicest, friendliest band I've ever met in my life.
Totally.
You've met them before?
Yeah,
they're just like
sure.
the nicest people in the world.
Awesome. Yeah, no, I agree.
Really, really good to see you. Thank you so much for coming on the show. You can hear Tyler Shaw's music on the Hit List channel, Top Deton channel, All Time Pop channel, and the Girl Party channel. That's the channel you want to be on. If I had me, I would want to be on the Girl Party channel.
I love that.
I'm just saying. It's a party all the time.
Perfect.
Tune in next time, guys. Bye.